Welcome all my dear student of FY BSc physics class. Today we are going to start third chapter of physics papers, first heat and thermodynamics. Okay, now before this, in second chapter, that is applied thermodynamics, we studied conversion of heat into work and its converse. We also studied second law of thermodynamics, concept of entropy, then temperature entropy diagram, after then first and second TdS equation, then Clausius Clapeyron latentity equation 1 and 2, and we also studied and we also solved many problems regarding to applied thermodynamics. Now in chapter number 3, that is heat transfer mechanism, we have to study Carnot's engine, which is theoretical heat engine, then Carnot cycle and efficiency of Carnot's engine. We have to also study the practical heat engine like auto engine and its efficiency, diesel engine and its efficiency. Okay, then we have to also study the refrigerator or concept of refrigeration, and then refrigerator, its application, and lastly we have to study the air conditioning mechanism, that is principle of air conditioning and applications or advantages and disadvantages of air conditioning. And lastly, we have to solve many problems regarding to heat transfer mechanism. Now in the chapter, that is heat transfer mechanism, we have to see, we have to study the definition of heat engine. Question is always arise that what is heat engine, and this question is very important for exam point of view. What is heat engine? Heat engine is a device which converts heat energy into mechanical work. What I say? Listen carefully. Heat engine is a device which converts heat energy into mechanical work. Then we have to see the principle of heat engine. On which principle heat engine works? The principle is very simple, and the principle is based on the property that heat by itself flows from a body at higher temperature to a body at low temperature. Have you got it? I am again going to repeat. The principle of heat engine is based on the property that heat by itself flows from a body at a higher temperature to a body at lower temperature. Okay, this is the principle of heat engine. Now one of the most important term is arise when we are going to study the heat engine, that is working substance. Working substance, what is working substance? The conversion of heat into work takes place with the help of substance known as working substance. Very important terminology this when we are going to study the heat engine. The question may be asked on this objective question, what is working substance? So listen carefully, I am again going to repeat. The working substance is nothing but the conversion of heat into work takes place with the help of a substance known as working substance. For example, in case of railway steam engine, steam is a working substance. Okay, now we are going to see the heat engine. There are generally two types of heat engine: theoretical heat engine and practical heat engine. today we are going to see first theoretical heat engine, which was proposed by a French physicist Sadi Carnot in 1824. Okay, what I say, Carnot heat engine is a first theoretical heat engine which does not come in actual practice. And this first theoretical heat engine was proposed by a French physicist Sadi Carnot in 1824. Okay, this engine is free from all the defects of practical heat engine because it was only on paper. So what I say, this Carnot heat engine, which is free from all the defects of practical heat engine. So Carnot heat engine, being an ideal reversible engine, cannot be released in actual practice. Its efficiency is maximum and it depends only on the working temperature. Carnot's heat engine. Okay, who discovered this? Sadi Carnot in 1824. This is theoretical heat engine. Heat engine. Okay, are you got it? Okay. I am again going to repeat briefly. Carnot heat engine was the first practical heat engine. This engine was proposed by Sadi Carnot, who was the French physicist. And this theoretical heat engine is free from all defects that of practical heat engine. So Carnot engine, being an ideal reversible engine, cannot be released in practice, actual practice, and its efficiency is maximum and is depends only on the working substance. Okay, so now we are going to see the Carnot heat engine in details. There are four important parts of Carnot heat engine. First one is cylinder. This cylinder C, first part. This is the first part of this Carnot heat engine. This cylinder contains 1 mole of a perfect gas. 1 mole of a perfect gas as a working substance. What is the working substance of this Carnot heat engine? 1 mole of a perfect gas is the working substance of heat engine. The cylinder is specially fitted with mobile and frictionless piston. What I say, the cylinder is fitted with mobile and frictionless piston. Now the piston can be moved during expansion, move off or move outwards during expansion, and move down or inwards during compression. The piston is moving outward during expansion and piston is moving inwards or down during compression. The material of the side walls as well as the piston is perfect insulator, while the base is perfect conductor. What I say, the piston can be move up during expansion and move down during compression, or move outwards during expansion, move downwards during move inwards during compression. The material of the side wall of the cylinder as well as the material of the piston is a perfect insulator, while the base of the cylinder is perfect conductor. This one insulator, perfect insulator, and this one is perfect conductor. Okay. Now the second part of this Carnot heat engine is the source of heat or heat reservoir. The sidewall and the base of this source H is perfect insulator, while the top of the source is conductor, proper conductor, pure conductor. Then third important part of this Carnot heat engine is insulating stand I. This is made up of perfectly insulating material. And the last part of this Carnot heat engine, that is part number 4, is sink. Side wall of the sink as well as base of the sink is made up of perfectly non-conducting material or insulating material, while the top is made up of conducting material. Okay. Remember that source of heat is, reservoir. It is the source of heat maintained at constant temperature, suppose T1, from which engine can draw heat. Okay. And one of the best characteristics of this source of heat is that it has infinite thermal capacity, and any amount of heat can be drawn from it without a change its temperature. So forever its temperature T1 remains constant. Similarly, the last part, sink is a cold body maintained at constant temperature T2. Remember that T1 is always greater than T2. This is high temperature, this is low temperature. This sink also has infinite thermal capacity, and any amount of heat can be given to the sink without a change in its temperature. Okay. This is about the important part of this. Then last one is insulating stand. Insulating stand, it is a perfect insulator on which, when cylinder is placed, system is totally isolated from that of surrounding. There is no thermal contact between system and surrounding. When cylinder is placed on the insulating stand, it can undergoes adiabatic expansion or compression. Why adiabatic? Because there is no thermal contact when cylinder is placed. When cylinder is placed on this insulating stand, then there is no thermal contact between system and surrounding, or in other words, we can say that system is totally isolated from that of surrounding. And so when cylinder is placed on insulating stand, the change may be either adiabatic expansion or may be adiabatic compression. Okay. Now we are going to see the Carnot cycle. Sadi Carnot in 1824 proposed a theoretical thermodynamic cycle regarding to this thermodynamic, sorry, regarding this Carnot engine. The working of Carnot engine involves a reversible cyclic change. What I say? The working of Carnot's engine involves a reversible cyclic change in the thermodynamic state of a perfect gas. This is very important. So, I am again going to repeat. The working of Carnot engine involves a reversible cyclic change in the thermodynamic state of a perfect gas. And a cycle, that is Carnot cycle, is a process in which system turns to its original state after a number of successive changes. What I say? A cycle, that is Carnot cycle, is a process in which the system turns to its original state after a number of successive changes. Carnot cycle consists of four operations. First operation is reversible isothermal expansion. Second operation or change is reversible adiabatic expansion. Third change is reversible isothermal compression. And last fourth change is reversible adiabatic compression. Okay. Now I am going to draw a Carnot cycle here. Suppose this is a P axis and this is a V axis. That is, along Y axis pressure is taken and along X axis there is a volume. And see here, there are these four changes C1, C2, C3 and C4. This is the Carnot cycle. In the beginning of this Carnot cycle, I told you that Carnot cycle is a process in which this system turns back or turns to its original state after number of successive changes. Okay, and I also told you that Carnot cycle consists of four operations, that is reversible isothermal expansion. Second one is reversible adiabatic expansion. Third one is reversible isothermal compression. And last, that is fourth, is reversible adiabatic compression. Okay. See here, the cycle C1, C2, C3, C4 and C1. This is the Carnot cycle. C1, C2, C3, C4 and C1. Now here, there are four parts. C1, C2 represents first change or first process, that is reversible isothermal expansion. At point C1, pressure is P1, volume is V1. And at point C2, pressure is P2 and volume is V2. This is isothermal expansion. Volume increases from V1 to V2, while pressure decreases from P1 to P2. But this change takes place at constant temperature T1. Okay, so C1 and C2, C1, C2 represent the first reversible isothermal expansion. During this isothermal expansion, the volume goes on increasing from V1 to V2 and pressure goes on decreasing from P1 to P2, but this change takes place at constant temperature and hence the name reversible isothermal expansion. Now second change, this is the second part of Carnot cycle, C2, C3. This C2, C3 represents reversible, okay. One of the thing I have to tell that during the first change, what happened? How Carnot's engine work? During the first change, that is during reversible isothermal expansion or simply during isothermal expansion, what happened? The cylinder is placed on the source. Cylinder is placed on the source. And when cylinder is kept on the source, what happened? Heat, the base of the cylinder is perfectly conducting, whereas top of the source is also perfectly conducting. When this system is placed on the source, what happens? There is exchange, or in a simple word we can say that one mole of a perfect gas can absorb heat from that of source very slowly. And when this gas absorbs heat from the source, what happens? Expansion of the gas takes place. That is, when cylinder is placed or kept on the source, this perfect gas absorbs heat from the source, its internal energy goes on increasing, and when internal energy of this gas goes on increasing, work is, expansion of the gas takes place, work is done by the gas on the piston, and that's why piston is moving in outward direction. But when this change is very slow, and as source of heat is having infinite heat capacity, then temperature of the sink and source remains constant. Okay. And during this change, initially the pressure and volume of the gas at point C1 is P1 and V2. And when change is completed, then at the final point, that is C2, pressure is P2 and volume is V2. As there is an expansion, volume is increasing from V1 to V2, and during expansion, pressure of the gas falls from P1 to P2. But remember that this change takes place at constant temperature T1. And this change is represented on this Carnot cycle by the curve C1, C2. Okay. Then heat absorbed is Q1. Q1 is the amount of heat. Say Q1 is the amount of heat absorbed by the gas from the source. And at the worth of this heat, when heat is absorbed, obviously work is done, and that's why piston is moving in outward direction. Then what will be the work done? Work done is W1. Q1 is the heat absorbed by the gas from the sink, and work is done W1. And this work done is nothing but, I have told you that VdV, integral V1 to V2, because this change is very slow. Okay. We know that for ideal gas, PV is equal to what? PV is equal to RT. So P is equal to RT upon V. Substitute this value of P in this equation. After substituting the value of P in equation this, then we have Q1 is equal to W1 is equal to integral V1 to V2 RT dV upon V. As R is Rydberg constant or gas constant, and T is the temperature. This change takes place as constant temperature. So we have RT, take RT outside the the integral v1 to v2 and dv upon v. When we solve this integral, we will get R T1. T1 is the temperature. R T1 ln v2 upon v1. This is the work done during isothermal expansion. Okay, are you got it? But when we consider this formula in order to calculate the work done during isothermal expansion, then it is not possible to obtain the answer. So we have to convert this natural logarithm into base log for base 10. So in simple word, we can say that Q1 is the heat absorbed by the gas during isothermal expansion, and due to this heat Q1, work W1 is done, and this work done is 2.303 RT log for base 10 V2 upon V1. This is the work done for or when isothermal expansion takes place. Okay. Now the second change, that is adiabatic expansion. Second change. What happens in adiabatic expansion? During this adiabatic expansion, the cylinder is the cylinder is removed from the source of heat, and this cylinder is placed on insulating stand. When cylinder is kept on insulating stand, what happens? When cylinder is placed on insulating stand, then insulating stand is perfectly insulating material, is made up of perfectly insulating material. When this system is placed on this insulating stand, what happens? System is totally isolated from that of surrounding, and then due to this there is no thermal contact between system and surrounding. Okay. Now when we adjust the pressure on the piston such that the piston is moving in outward direction, again we are going to, when we kept this cylinder on insulating stand, again we have to adjust the pressure on the piston so that adiabatic expansion takes place. And when adiabatic expansion takes place, what happens? Internal energy of the gas goes on decreasing, because this gas uses some part of its internal energy in order to perform the work on the piston, and that's why piston is moving in outward direction. Okay, but when there is a decrease in internal energy, obviously temperature of the gas falls from T1 to T2. Okay. That means what happens during adiabatic expansion, when cylinder is placed on insulating stand, then there is no thermal contact between the system and surrounding, and when we adjust the pressure on the piston so that adiabatic expansion takes place, or when the external pressure on the piston is so adjusted that the gas expanded adiabatically, work is done by the gas on the piston, that's why piston is moving in outward direction. Since no heat enters or leaves the system, because system and surrounding is totally isolated from each other, and that's why the temperature of the system or temperature of the gas falls or decreasing from T1 to T2. So in adiabatic expansion, what happens? There is a change in pressure changes from P2 to P3, that is there is a fall in pressure from P2 to P3, there is a increase in volume from V2 to V3, but as system is isolated from the surrounding, there is a fall in temperature, and temperature falls from T1 to T2. Okay, During the change, again, work done W2 is integral form V2 to V3 PdV. Again, we have to consider the adiabatic relation between pressure and volume, that is PV raised to gamma is equal to constant, which we already studied in chapter number first. So by using this adiabatic relation, we can calculate the work done, and this work done will be W2 is equal to R in bracket T1 minus T2 upon gamma, or sorry, gamma minus 1. Then this is already studied in chapter number first, work done adiabatic relation and work done during adiabatic change. And by using this, we can calculate the work done during this adiabatic expansion in the Carnot cycle. This work done is W2 is equal to R T1 minus T2 upon gamma minus 1. So this is the work done during second change. Now we are going to see the chapter change number 3. Now in this isothermal compression, and during isothermal compression, what happens? System is removed from the insulating stand and placed on the sink. When system is removed from the insulating stand and placed or kept on the sink, yes, sink, both the sink and a gas are at the same temperature T2, the external pressure on the piston is so adjusted that means pressure should be increased. So external pressure on the piston is so adjusted that the slow compression of the gas takes place. Slow compression of the gas takes place, and when slow compression of the gas takes place, what happens? Volume goes on decreasing from V3 to V4, and pressure goes on increasing from T3 to T4. That is, there is a slight increase in pressure and there is a decrease in volume. Volume decreases from V3 to V4, and pressure increases from P3 to P4. This is the exact opposite to isothermal expansion, and this change takes place at constant temperature T2. So during isothermal compression, there is change in pressure and volume, but temperature constant, second temperature, and that temperature is a temperature of sink. So when we calculate the work done, Q2, we can say that Q2, Q1 is the amount of heat absorbed from the source, and Q2 is the amount of heat given to the sink. And this heat, when is rejected, when this heat is rejected, obviously work is done by the piston on the gas, and that's why the work done is negative. So Q2 is the work done, and this, when this heat is rejected, at that time work is done, and that is nothing but W3, and this is V3 to V4 PdV. Again, solve this integral. When we solve this integral, we already solved this integral, solve this in chapter number first. So work done during this expansion is minus 2.303 RT2 for log base 10 V3 V4, V3 by V4. Remember that this negative sign indicates the work is done on the gas. You have to kept in your mind that when work is done by the gas on the piston, this is positive work done, and when work is done by the piston on the gas, this is negative work done. Okay, negative sign indicates that work is done on the gas, and positive sign indicates that work is done by the gas. Okay, and now this change is, third change is represented by C3, C4, and last change C4, C1. This is nothing but adiabatic compression. Then, now again, the system is removed from the sink and kept on insulating stand, and pressure on the piston is slowly increasing. In this step, when cylinder is removed from the sink and placed on the insulating stand, once again, when we adjust the pressure on the piston, so that the external pressure on the piston is so adjusted that the gas is compressed adiabatically. The compression is continued till the temperature of the gas increases from T1 to T2 and gas comes back to its original state C1, and this change is represented by the curve C4 C1. In this way, there are four changes. These four changes are completed, and during this last change, we have to calculate the work done. When this reversible change or adiabatic compression takes place, obviously the work done is exactly opposite to this, and this work done is W4 is equal to R in bracket T2 minus T1 upon gamma minus 1. Here T1 minus T2, because this term, this work done is exactly opposite. This is the work done by the gas on the piston during expansion, adiabatic expansion, and this is the work done by the piston on the gas during adiabatic compression. Okay, so these two work done are exactly equal and opposite. When this change is completed, again here, or we can write this change like this. W4 is equal to minus R T1 minus T2 upon gamma minus 1. Again here we can say that this is the exactly opposite to this, and negative sign indicates that work is done on the gas, not by the gas. Okay. The change in the state shown by C4 C1. Okay. Figure shows the working substance starts from C1 and come back to C1 after four operation: C1, C2, C2, C3, C3, C4 and C4, C1. And hence the cycle C1, C2, C3, C4, C1 is called Carnot cycle. Okay. Now, due to lack of time, it is not possible to carry the remaining part of this point. So, in next lecture, we will obtain the expression for efficiency of Carnot heat engine. Till then, we shall stop here. Have a good day. Thank you.